Hello everyone. In the previous class, we have learned how to convert the regular expressions into an automata. That means we built an epsilon NFA with the help of the regular expressions given. So this was a kind of a translation that we did. In today's class, we are going to learn how to build a regular expression from the given finite state machine. So therefore, an automata is given to you. From this automata, we have to develop the regular expression. So this regular expression should match the set of the strings that have to be accepted by the DFA. So therefore, we have an algorithm FSM to regular expression heuristic, and M here is represented by the FSM. So we'll see the different steps that are there, and we'll have to follow the same steps in order to make the conversion. So the first step that we have to follow is, if there are any dead states in the DFA, in the automata, we are going to just eliminate it, because we know that anything that leads to a dead state will never accept. So therefore, we are eliminating the dead state. So remove any state which is not reachable from the start state. So the second step is, in case the FSM has got no accepting states at all, then it can't accept any strings. Therefore, that regular expression is given by a null. Next, if the start state has got an incoming arrow, then create a new start state and connect it with the epsilon transition. So suppose we have a state here that is nothing but the start state, and we have any incoming arrow to the start state. So in that case, we are going to create a new start state, and we are going to connect this old start state to the via the epsilon transition. So this is what the step 3 states. If the start state has an incoming arrow, then create a new start state. So this is a new start state that we have created, and connect it with the epsilon transition to the old start state. Next, if there are more than one accepting states, then create the new finite state, final state, and connect the old final states to the new final state via the epsilon transition. Make the old final state as non-final state. Now suppose we have more than one final state in the automata. So suppose we have two states here which are both final states. Then what we are supposed to do is to create a new final state. So this is a new final state that we are creating. Connect both the final states via the epsilon transition, and make the old final states as the non-final state. So this is the procedure that we are going to follow in case if any automata has got more than one accepting states. We'll move on to the next step. So the next step states that at this point, so after analyzing the start state and after analyzing the final state, so after this point, if the start state is equal to the final state, so that means after we've done all this, if the start state itself is the final state, so this is the start state and the same state is also a final state, then epsilon is the regular expression. And also it should also satisfy the condition that this state is the only state in the entire automata. So both the conditions have to be satisfied. First one is the start state itself has to be the final state, and the second condition that it has to satisfy is this is the only state in the entire automata. Then the regular expression that is given from this kind of an automata is nothing but a epsilon. Next, if neither of these conditions are true, neither of the conditions are nothing but there is no only one state which is equal to the start state, and at least there is one accepting state, then we'll have to follow 6.1, 6.2, 6.3. Along with this, we'll have to also do the 3 and 4. So now, first thing for every automata that we are going to do is find out if there is any incoming arrow to the start state. Then you create a new start state and connect it to the old one via the epsilon transition. Next step that you are going to do is, you will have to check whether the automata has got more than one final state. In case it has got more than one final state, we have to create a new final state and connect both accepting states via the epsilon transitions. And the old ones will no more be the final states, and the new one is the only final state. Then we'll have to select some state and remove it from the automata. While removing, we have to label the transitions with the regular expression. So this is what we are going to do. So first thing we will examine is, remove any state which is not reachable from the start state. So we'll examine this problem now. So we'll see what is the state, or if there is any state which is not reachable from the start state, or we'll consider any state which is a dead state. So as you can see, Q3 has got only incoming arrows and there are no outgoing arrows at all. So this state is actually a dead state. So therefore, what we are going to do is eliminate this state Q3. So when we form the solution, we'll go step by step, and the second step is to examine that Q3 is a dead state and eliminate that state from the problem. This is Q2. This is, we've not marked, this is 0 and this is 1, this is 0 and this is 1. So all the transitions which are connecting to Q3 and its own loop, all of them are eliminated from the problem. So this is what it looks like after you have done the first step. Then we'll go to the second step. If the FSM has no accepting states, then the regular expression is a null. So it's not true in this case because we have at least one final state. So the second step won't work for this problem. We'll go to the third step next. If the start state has an incoming arrow, then create a new start state and connect it with the epsilon transition. So what we examine from the start state here, you can see that there is one incoming arrow and the second incoming arrow to the start state. So in this case, it is required that we create a new start state, and then via the epsilon transition, we connect it to the old start state, and then we make or keep the rest of the transitions as it is. So this is Q1, and here this is Q2, and this is 0 and 1. So this is a new start state that we have created, and we have connected to the entire automata via the epsilon transition. Then after we do that, we'll go to the fourth step. If there are more than one accepting states, then create. So if there are more than one accepting states, so come here and examine if there are more than one accepting states. There is only one accepting state here. So the fourth step won't hold good for this problem. Fifth one. So we have finished step 1 to 4. So go to step 5 and see, at this point, if the start state is equal to final state. First of all, the start state is not equal to the final state, and there is more than one states in this automata. So therefore, the fifth step will also not hold good. Then we'll have to go to sixth step and follow them in loop. Select some state to eliminate, remove that state, and modify the transitions with some regular expression. So that is why this entire method is called as the state elimination method. So we are going to eliminate every state apart from the start state and the final state. So the only states that will remain in this automata at the end of the elimination is the start state and the final state. But the rest of all the intermediate states are going to be eliminated, but we are going to label the transitions with the equivalent regular expressions so that the meaning doesn't change. So we have finished this now. Now we'll go on selecting one after another state to eliminate. So next, we will choose Q2 for elimination. So in case if we choose Q2 for elimination, the rest of the states are going to remain as it is. So this is an epsilon and this is the final state. Also this is 0 and this is 1 and this is Q1. Now in case I want to eliminate everything which is here, but still I have to accept the strings that are acceptable by the state to Q0 to Q1. So this So now we are going to eliminate this Q2. If we want to try to eliminate this Q2, we are going to preserve the set of the strings which are accepted between this Q0 and Q2. So therefore the string that is accepted between this Q0 and Q2 is, from Q0 you can go to Q2 via 1, and from Q2 back to Q0 you are going on 0. So I can directly write a loop here on 1 and 0 and eliminate this Q2. The result will be just the same. So this is nothing but going to Q2 and then again coming back to Q0. Coming back to Q0 is a loop itself, and on the loop we have the symbols 0 and 1. So next what we are going to do is eliminate this Q1. So in case if you want to eliminate this Q1, understand that if the state is not there, then we have to have these two transitions as it is. So therefore what are the transitions? So Q0 to Q1 and then from Q1 to Q0. So the arrows are leaving this Q0 and coming back to Q0 again. So therefore it is a loop, rather not the state. So this is an epsilon, this is the state. So therefore here we can write a loop. So on the loop we are going to write 0, 1. So this is 0 and 1. And 1, 0 which was there earlier will remain as it is. So this is nothing but Q0 and this is Q1. So after we have formed this, we are left now with only two states. What are the two states? That is the start state and the final state. So this is the point at which you are going to write the regular expression for the entire thing. So therefore when you write the regular expression here, what is this? So this is Q0, so it has got an epsilon, so I am going to write here epsilon. Then after this you have, from Q1 the first transition is nothing but 1, 0, and the second transition is 0, 1. So from Q1 to Q1 you have two transitions. The first transition is 1, 0, the second transition is 0. That means from Q1 to Q1 you can either go on 1, 0 or on 0, 1. Both are also loops. Therefore, we should not forget to put this star here. So the entire regular expression is nothing but this epsilon concatenated with anything will give you the same thing. It is the identity of concatenation. So therefore, the regular expression is 1, 0 or 0, 1 any number of times. When you look at the initial problem statement, you can see that this is the final state. So therefore what are the strings that we are accepting? We may accept 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. So that 0, 1 is repeating n number of times. So this is the accepting state, the second path, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. So this 1, 0 is again repeating any number of times. So therefore this entire automata is either able to take up 0, 1 any number of times or 1, 0 any number of times. So if we look at the same regular expression here, that is what we also have derived. So this is the end of this problem. So now we will solve the second problem. So if you look at the problem here, we will go to the first step and check if there is any states which are dead states. So when you examine the solution here, there are no dead states. So all of them, all the states have got at least one outgoing arrow except for the final state. So the first step does not hold good. Then we'll go to the second step and we'll see the second step here. And we'll see that there is at least one final state. Therefore, the second step will also not hold good. Then we'll go to the third step and say or ask whether the starting state has got any incoming arrow. So there is first outgoing arrow and there is second outgoing arrow. So there is no incoming arrow here. So there is no need to create a new start state. Then we'll go to the fourth one. So if there are more than one accepting states, so you can see that there is only one accepting state here. So therefore, the fourth step will also not hold good. Now we directly move to selecting some state each time for elimination and renaming the transitions with the regular expressions for the same. So the choice of removing the states is anything except the start state and the final state. So finally, after eliminating all the states, we should be left only with the start state and final state. So we'll perform the first step and I will choose state 2 to eliminate. So state 2 has to be eliminated, but then the transitions and the kind of the strings that are accepted by this DFA should not change. So we'll write the rest of it as it is. So all this remains the same. So the 2 has to be eliminated, but then we can see that from 1 on B it is going to 2, and again on B it is going to 3. So therefore the transition is moving through 2 from 1 to 3. So therefore I can directly write a arrow mark from 1 to 3. So from 1 to 3, what are the different things which are there on the transitions? So it is B followed by the second B. So likewise, what we have done here is, instead of moving from 1 to 3 through this 2, directly we are moving from 1 to 3 via this B and this B. So BB is the regular expression that I am going to write here. So next thing what we are going to do, you can see that 1, 2, 3, it is going on this transition also, and 1, 2, 3, we are moving on this transition also. So therefore, 2 move from 1 to 3, either you can choose this transition or you can choose this transition. Therefore, the same thing can be written as from 1 to 3, there are two choices. One is on a A or. So when I say or, it is nothing but the union sign. Union, the second choice of moving from 1 to 3 is over a BB. So I am going to write here BB. So this is a regular expression on the transition that we write after eliminating this transition. The rest of the things are going to remain the same. So B is going to remain as B, and on A we are going to 4. So next, this is never a choice for elimination, and this is also never a choice for elimination because this is the start state and final state. So next step is that we have to remove this 3. So I choose 3 to eliminate. So therefore, we are going to write the transitions here. So directly, the transition has to go from 1 to 4. Without having 3 in between. So therefore now A union BB is going to remain as it is. We are going to put a bracket around that because we are going to start another set of regular expression. After that it is followed by any number of B's. So any number of B's is going to be B star. Next, after B star, it is followed by a A. So I am going to write here a A. So this is the regular expression that we are going to form, because the only states which are left are the start state and final state. Once we are left only with the start state and final state, this is nothing but our regular expression. So therefore, the regular expression is equal to A union BB B star A. We'll see whether we have formed the correct regular expression. So when you look at this diagram here, will try to form some strings. So some strings that can be accepted are B, B, A. So B, B, A. B, B, A. Next, A, B star, A. So A, B star, A is nothing but any number of B's followed by a. So it could also be possible that we may have three B's and A's. So 1, 2, 3, 4, A. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and A. Okay. So these are few strings that can be accepted by the machine. So we'll see if the same thing can be accepted by the regular expression that we have framed, because the set of strings is represented as a automata here, and here it is represented as a regular expression. So we'll take up the first string. So that is nothing but B, B and A. So from this I'm choosing B, B, because I can choose either A or B, B. So I'm choosing B, B. Next it should be followed by a. So for this B we are putting to the power of 0. So therefore this part will never come. Then A is there. So A is here. Next string, A, B, 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 A. So from here, from this part, I am choosing A. After that, 3 is there. So I am going to put here 3. So 3 instead of star there, 3 repetitions of B. So 3 repetitions of B will come. After that, the last A will come. Next, we have any number of B's here followed by a. So from the first thing, I'm going to pick up 2 B's. After that, from here, we are going to pick up 2 more B's, giving it as B to the power of 2. And at last, I'm going to have a. So whatever we see here is nothing but everything is always ending with a. And then the string can either have any number of A and B, B's in between. So if A is there, a single A has to come. Otherwise, B's have to repeat in terms of 2's. So we'll look at this problem now. So in this problem, I have written few strings here that can be accepted by this DFA. So if you want to accept A, we are going to accept at 2. So A and B, we are accepting at 1. AAB, so AAB, we are accepting here. Then you have 4 A's followed by a B. So 1, and then you have 2, then 3, 4, then B, triple A, B, A. So 1, 2, 3, B and A. So these are some random strings that are accepted by this machine. So what we are going to do is frame a regular expression for the strings that are accepted by this machine. So we'll go with the state elimination method as it is. So as we can see here, there is at least outgoing arrow from every state, so there is no dead state here. Second step that we are going to see is whether we do not have any final state. We have 2 final states here, so second step is also not possible. We'll go to the third step, and the third step states that in case the start state has got an incoming arrow, yes, definitely the start state has got an incoming arrow. So therefore we create a new start state and then connect it via the epsilon transition to the old start state, and the rest of the transitions are going to remain as it is. The two. Okay, so the rest of the transitions are as it is. Next. Next step is, in case the automata has got 2 different final states, then create a new final state and connect both of them via the epsilon transition to the new final state. So therefore, I'm going to write the diagram here. This is 1, and then rather I'll write it here. So this is the automata that we have written and carried forward from the previous step. I have removed the final state representations from 1 and 2 because I'm going to create a new final state and naming it as 4, and via the epsilon transitions I'm going to connect it to the 4. So this is how we perform the step 4. So after we have done this, we are now going to eliminate the states one by one. So we'll choose 3 for elimination first. So we'll write the automata and the corresponding transitions. So this is 1, yes. So state number 3 is going to be eliminated. So we'll see what kind of a transition it is, and we'll see from where to where we are going via 3. So from 2 we are starting, and via 3 we are going to 1. So we are basically moving from state number 2 to state number 1 via 3. So state number 2 to state number 1, let's put a transition. So on this transition we are going to write all the symbols that are there on the transitions. So this is a B here, and this is also a B. So the first symbol that appears on the transition is a. So write A here. After that, it is on the loop A states that it is a star. So we'll write A star. After that, it is followed by a B. So we are going to write here B. Also, when you look at the two transitions here, 2 to 1 you're going on B, and again from 2 to 1 you're going on this transition also. So there are two transitions that is taking you from the same state to another state. So what we can do is we can eliminate one transition, and right here in the same expression you can go from 2 to 1 via B or a star b. So this is this transition or this transition. So B or a star b. So this plus and union can be used interchangeably to say that it is a OR symbol. Next, so we'll follow the next step here. So next, what we are going to do is eliminate 2. And 4 will remain. So 1 to 4 we have a transition, that is epsilon, and 2 we are going to eliminate. So in case if you want to eliminate 2, we'll see what are the different transitions that is using this 2. So the first transition that is using this 2 is from 1 to 2, then 2 back to 1. So that means we are going from 1 and coming back to 1. So therefore I'm going to write a loop on 1. So what are the symbols that are leading for this loop? So the symbols are A followed by A followed by this entire expression. So A followed by B plus a star b. This is the loop that we are going. So A followed by this entire expression. So that is what we have written here, A followed by this entire expression. Then there is second arrow which is going from 2. From 2 we are reaching this 4. So therefore what we are doing is from 1 we are starting, 2 we are going, and from 2 we are reaching 4. So therefore we are reaching from 1 to 4. So now we have arrived at a step where 0 is the start state and 4 is the final state. So we are going to preserve this 0 and 4, and we are going to eliminate 1. So once we try to eliminate 1, we are going to draw the transitions only between this 0 and the state 4. So we are going to eliminate 1 and we are going to preserve the state 0 and state 4, which are the start state and final state. So we'll see how to do it. First of all, on 1 we have a loop on the entire expression, so therefore this entire expression will have a star on it. So what we are going to do is, I'm going to split it up and write AB plus A star B. So two things are there here, A and A star. So if I append this A here, it's going to be A star and B. For this entire thing, I'm going to add a star. Next is, the next transition from 1 is, from 1 we are going to 4 and also we are going to 4. So there are two different things which is taking from 1 to 4. So from 1 to 4 you can either go on A or you can go on epsilon. So here we are going to write epsilon or A. So from 0 to 4 via 1, you can either go on epsilon or go on A. So epsilon or A. So this is the final expression that we are going to derive from the given problem. So therefore, the final regular expression is AB plus AAA star B whole star epsilon or A. So we'll see if the strings that we have written here can be accepted or not by this expression. So first one is just a. So it is a star here, so therefore this entire expression can be eliminated, and between this epsilon or a, I'm going to choose a. So therefore RE is equal to A will be accepted. Then I have AB which has to be accepted. So if AB has to be accepted, I'm going to choose AB from here and I'm going to choose epsilon from here. So therefore AB is accepted. Next we have AAB. So AAB, in case if I choose this expression, AA is chosen from here, A star can be 0 followed by a B. So AAB will be chosen, and from here I'm going to choose epsilon. So the entire string that you're going to form is a AAB. So similarly, you can verify with the rest of the expressions from the given initial automata and check whether the regular expression is also accepting the same strings. So this is the end of converting a given automata into a regular expression.